Rahim. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Today we will be learning about development in human fetus and formation of twins. What is actually fertilization? During copulation, men ejaculate semen with about 300 to 500 million sperms into the woman's vagina. The sperms swim through cervix into the uterus. Less than 3,000 sperms are able to reach the fallopian tube. Fertilization occurs when one sperm succeeds in penetrating the secondary oocyte in the fallopian tube. This is followed by changes to the secondary oocytes, known as fertilization membrane, that prevents penetration from other sperms. Upon entry of the sperm, the nucleus of secondary oocyte immediately complete second meiotic division to form the ovum and another polar body. The sperm nucleus and the ovum nucleus fuse to produce a diplozygote, is known as fertilization. After fertilization, a 9-month gestation period starts. After fertilization takes place, which form a diploid zygote, the zygote will undergo multiple division through mitosis. As you can see here, this is unfertilized secondary oocyte. The sperm try to penetrate in the secondary oocyte. Once the sperm succeed to penetrate into it, this is called as fertilization process, which the sperm's nucleus and ovum nucleus will fuse together, and after fertilization, it will form diploid zygote, and the zygote will divide into two cells through the process as we call as mitosis. Two cells and into four cells and eight cells, and then it will form into morula. Morula is a solid ball. Then it's beginning to enter the uterus. Once morula enter the uterus, division of morula will proceed and morula will transform into blastocyst. And then blastocyst will then implant in the endometrium, and this is called as implantation. As you can see here, this is blastocyst, and then it will implant at the endometrium. This is endometrium. This is called as the process of implantation. The blastocyst continues to grow into an embryo. The unborn baby we call as embryo. From first week to 8 weeks, and after that we will call it as a zygote. Role of the placenta and umbilical artery. Umbilical cord consists of umbilical vein and umbilical artery. As you can see here, this is umbilical cord. This is umbilical vein and umbilical artery. Umbilical vein, its function to transport oxygenated blood from placenta to the fetus, from mom to fetus. it will transport in the blood, it will transport oxygen, nutrients such as glucose and amino acid, and antibodies. Umbilical artery, the function is to transport the oxygenated blood from fetus to the placenta, such as carbon dioxide and urea. The importance of placenta. Placenta is important to be an exchange site of substances. As you all know, at the placenta, they have umbilical vein and umbilical artery. So the umbilical vein is function to transport the substance from mom to the fetus, such as oxygen, nutrients, antibodies, and hormones. The example of the nutrient is glucose and amino acid, while the function of umbilical artery is to transport a substance from the fetus, from the baby, to the mom, such as carbon dioxide and urea. Placenta is also important to secrete hormone, such as human chorionic gonadotropin. The placenta will produce the HCG during pregnancy. The level of this hormone will increase at the early stages of the pregnancy and will double every 2 or 3 days for the first 4 weeks of pregnancy. The main function of HCG to maintain the structure of the corpus luteum and maintain the secretion of the progesterone. While the secretion of progesterone is maintained, it will maintain the thickness of the endometrium. This hormone can be detected from the urine of the mother. Why fetal and maternal blood don't mix? Fetal is the baby and maternal is the mom. It's to prevent blood coagulation, avoid ruptured fetal blood vessel, and block the entry of certain toxins and pathogens such as microorganisms like virus, protozoa, fungus, algae, and bacteria that can cause a disease to the baby and to the mom.
Obviously, first, we will learn that there are 3 types of twins. First is identical twin, second is paternal twins, and third is conjoined twin. So, what is identical twin and how it is formed? Identical twin happens when there is one sperm fertilized with one ovum to form an embryo. The embryo will split and form 2 zygotes from one placenta. So, how about paternal twins? Paternal twins happen when there are 2 sperm fertilized with 2 ovum to form 2 separate embryos. Both embryos will develop from different placenta. As you can see, there are certain similarities and differences between identical twins, paternal twins, and conjoined twins. Number of sperms and ovum for identical twins and conjoined twins is same, but different for paternal twins. The division of embryo for identical twins is complete, while conjoined twin is incomplete and still fused together. Conjoined twin may also share 1 or 2 internal organs. Number of placenta and genetic component for identical twins and conjoined twins is same, but paternal twins have 2 number of placenta and different genetic component. The gender of identical twin and conjoined twin is usually same, but paternal twins can have same or different gender.